At Glitch, we like to remix our apps, building on the old app to create a whole new app. I remixed Starter A-Frame to make Starter A-Frame fancy. It's just like Starter A-Frame, but I've added some really cool stuff. You can see the planets look way more realistic, and there's an asteroid belt. This is through the magic of assets and 3D models. We'll show you how to use those.
Let's take a look at the code in Starter A-Frame Fancy. I'm going to create a remix, that way I can edit it to my heart's content. Just like the first starter, when you first remix it, you'll be taken to this Readme, and the Readme has all kinds of helpful information about what the code does and how to edit it, and even some ideas for customizing it. Let's take a look at our scene by clicking the Show button. You can click and drag to move around, and as you can see, these aren't simple spheres anymore. They have more realistic textures, and there's this asteroid belt. So how did this happen? So the spheres have image textures, and this asteroid belt is a 3D model. How does this work? Well, if you want to upload images and models to Glitch, you're going to head to the Assets section. An Assets section is where you can take anything and just drag it in and then use it on a Glitch. So here's my models, and here's the images that have nice previews, and I'm going to upload a new planet texture I found on Wikimedia. It's an equirectangular image, so it should look really great on a sphere. All I have to do is drag it in. Great, here it is. Now it has a unique URL, and I'm going to use that, so I'm going to copy it. That way, I can put it into my code. Now I've headed over to index.html, where my code is. I'm just going to paste that URL right here for now, just to keep it in mind so that I don't forget it. Obviously, I'm not going to memorize it. And I'm going to take one of these image tags, because I know it's a texture, and it's similar to the textures that are already on the planets, because it's an image. So let's just copy one of these. Copy and paste. Great. What's this error here? Well, let's mouse over and see. Okay, so IDs, think of them as unique names. And if they have the same name and you try to reference a name, it's going to get confused. So we want to have unique names so that we can use it later and not have to worry about it getting mixed up. So I'm going to change it from sun texture to a name that has been used before. Cool texture. Alright, but this URL is still the sun URL. I'm going to take my URL from assets that I saved here, and I'm going to cut it, which copies it and removes it, and then I'm going to paste it into SRC. Awesome, now we can use this texture. So I'm going to take my scene and drag it into a new window so that I can see it while I'm editing. And now we're going to see what we want to edit. So let's try out this texture on the sun. Right now the sun is using sun texture, which is up here. But let's change this value to cool texture. Awesome! Well, try this out for yourself, and we hope you have fun, and we're really excited to see your cool remixes.
I use the Google Streetview app, which I think is amazing because everyone can download it on their phone. And so with that, you take this spherical image that's composed of maybe 20 something different images from all different vantage points. And then Google stitches it together. And if you just import that photo and set it to one of these like panoramic view objects, like it pretty well creates this image. I don't have one of those super fancy cameras where you have many lenses and they're all shooting out and they're taking a perfect picture, even though I would love to have something like that, and I'm sure that works beautifully. I've tried using the Google Cardboard app, which it lets you take a panoramic image, but it doesn't do, you don't take images above you or below you, but so those parts are blurry and all around you. It's like this really nice image. But one super cool thing about it is that it records sound while you are taking the image. And I find that is just like a really powerful experience whenever you look back at these images and you are hearing either like background noises or people talking or like a song that's playing in the background, it really takes you back there in a really powerful way. So I think it's really cool that the Google Cardboard app also captures audio. And I think that they do it in like a 360 audio type of way too. So I think it's a great app.
Has a super useful tool built into it. It's called A-Frame Inspector. And to access it, you go to your scene and press Ctrl-L-I on Windows or Ctrl-Option-I on Mac. Let's head to our scene and try it out. Let's click Show. This is our scene. And since I'm on a Mac, I'm going to do Ctrl-Option-I. Awesome, I just opened the inspector. Now, on the left side, you can see all the elements of our scene. You can click on them to learn more. The details are displayed on this right pane. I'm going to move around and take a look at some of our planets. For example, here's Jupiter. I can take these arrows and drag it around. And if I like this position, I can take these values and put them in our code. I can also change things like the radius and see what it looks like. For example, I'll change it from 2.5 to 10. The A-Frame Inspector has tons of capabilities. Check out the documentation for more information, and we hope you find that super useful as you're working on your starter projects.
So in this video, we learned about customizing our A-frame scene with images and models. And if you want to see it for yourself and remix it, go to starteraframefancy.glitch.me. And in the next video, we're going to update our app and add animation.